Vive le français! Bonjour les amis, j'espère que vous allez bien. Today I'm going to tell you about apartment and housing, housing in France, and how about the French home. So anyway, I will show you all this, but how is it? For a long, long time, until 1970, it was not very good. Let me tell you, it was not very good. I remember, even in this place where I'm in the countryside, the toilet, there was no tout à l'égout. Tout à l'égout, it means when you flush the toilet, before it would just go outside in the garden. Outside in the garden, you know. And they finally get the network from outside, on the main road, so now you have the pipes that can go there, you have the facilities. It was the same for the television, for the electricity, even for the internet. It took a lot of time before it reached all the places, all over France. Now it's not at all the same. So you had, for instance, here, you had the toilet outside in the garden. And that's the thing, if you live really in the countryside, like off-grid, you need a toilet sèche. Toilet sèche is you go to the toilet and it goes inside some kind of thing, and then every few months you need to empty it. So there's a truck coming and you need to empty it. Now it's not at all the same, okay? And now people in France have a good place, you can see. We have the bath. Most people have the bath. There is the shower room. On average, the size of the apartment in all of France is about 90 square meter, 90 to 100 square meter, so it's three rooms, so it's rather big. The regulation in France will state that you need to have a minimum comfort. You cannot do whatever you want. So the law will say that one room should be at least 9 square meter, and the size, the ceiling, the height should be at least 2 meter 20. So this is, by the way, there is a big debate for this, because we have in France what we call les marchands de sommeil. Les marchands de sommeil, they are the people who rent the very cheap room. You can be in this room, you can sleep there, and it's very cheap. Many people, they don't have money to pay the rent, because they cannot afford the rent, so they will live in this underground, sometimes in the basement, sometimes, and it's a very small apartment, and it's cheap, but everything is very old, the toilet doesn't work well, the painting goes away, the ceiling is very low, the rooms are very small, and you pay usually on the black, or sometimes it's legal, but then it's forbidden by the government. So at some point, the government will come and they will fine the owner, and they could even send him to jail. But on one side, the owners, they will say, hey, look, these guys, they are mainly migrants or poor people. They cannot pay the rent. They have to work in the city. I provide for them a cheap rent, and you, the government, you stop me from providing a cheap rent, because you say this is not good, this is not human, ce n'est pas salubre. And then the government cannot provide any HLM, the government cannot help the poor people, they don't have enough cheap apartment, So it's very controversial, it's a very controversial issue. You see what happens, many people in France, you have many associations, On one side, you have some French people are very wealthy, so they will have the apartments, they will invest in the cities, they will have apartments, for them it's just the investment, they don't live in the apartment. You have many foreigners who are very wealthy, they don't know what to do with their money, they come to France, they buy big apartment in Paris, because it's a big investment, it's Paris, Paris is never going to lose. It's Paris, the city center, Paris, there's only one Paris in the world, so they buy the big apartment. And then these apartments are empty. So you have associations, they will come, they will break the door, and they will put families inside, and they will tell them, you can stay there and sleep there, and the police cannot kick you out because it's winter time, you cannot kick people out. And then the police needs to sue, the owner needs to sue. It can take 1 year, 2 years, three years. There's some people who do the squatting, they will come here and take possession of your. So there's a big fight going on. On one side you have the owner, and on one side you have this association, and then the association, they will help poor people, and these poor people are almost all of them, they are migrants, not French national, who come, they have many, many families, or big families, they are refugees, and they come here, So it's very controversial, and it's difficult to say. And then the owner, many of the owner, some of them are French national, but many of the owner are also foreigners who just invest in France. And these are the social issues. Anyway, for the comfort, it's complicated also. Also, when you think, in fact, many people who are poor in France, who have big families, they live in the small place like this, they come from countries where the place where they live is already very, very bad. And based on the law, it will not be acceptable in France. Like the place where I've been where I've been living in China for maybe 10, 12 years, was not too French standard. You know, the painting goes away, the material I think are bad for your health, the selling is very low, but that's how people live in China. That's how people live in China. Most people live in places like this, or I've been living in places like this. So of course, even they come to France, they can, these guys, they will accept it. They don't see anything weird with it. But then the French system is not about this. So it's very complex. What else can I tell you? The equipment. So people in France, most of them, they have the fridge, they have the washing machine for the clothes, they have the stove, four stove. And however, there are few people who have the drying machine to dry the clothes. There are few of them to clean the plate. It depends. More and more people have it to clean the plate, washing machine for the plate. You know, dishwasher. Not all French people have this. You have many more and more robots, more and more equipment that people will use on the everyday life. The coffee machine, many French people have the coffee machine. The tea machine, now you have the tea machine. All this is the cost, in fact. I believe it's a little bit stupid. Even people don't have so much earnings, they will buy this machine. Oh, I need a coffee machine every day. Then they will use this small capsule. Now they cannot pay the cheap coffee, and they need to take it every day. Then many people will get, now there's the yogurt machine, and there's this kind of machine, and there's the mixer, and there's this. Some of these machines are useful, but some of them is. But the equipment makes your life, is supposed to make your life easier. So people are going to invest in this. Okay, je vous laisse. À bientôt, les amis. Au revoir. Take care. À bientôt.